Hello guys, this is Harless58 signing on to do a quick video review of the JBL Power Up wireless charging speaker. Says for Nokia. JBL and Nokia partnered up to deliver this device. If you guys don't know, basically it's a Bluetooth speaker that has tap to play with via NFC. Also, it has a Qi charger up top on the top of the speaker. So you guys can see some of the functionality. See, easy to connect, tap to play with Bluetooth audio using NFC, massive JBL sound, blah blah blah, made for Nokia Lumia. And also, it says right here you can place your Qi compatible phone on top of speaker for wireless charging, blah blah blah. Available in white, cyan, and black. My wife got me the black for Christmas. Okay, I would do a unboxing, but I got it for Christmas, like I said, so I kind of already unboxed it. You guys can see what the box looks like on the inside. I mean, yeah, I'm not gonna go through that, but it's well put together. It's a nice box, nice packaging. Okay, so move this on out of the way and make room for what you guys came to see. Okay, just put that whatever. And here it is. Okay, so this is the JBL speaker. It's not huge. I have pretty big hands. I'm able to grab it with essentially one hand. It's nice. Check out the bottom. See some FCC stuff on the bottom about QI or the Qi compatibility, the rubberized stands on the bottom to make sure it doesn't slide around. It's the front of the speaker. Two subwoofers or speakers that they have. It's the top right here. You really can't see it, but the illumination for the kind of like the outlines for where the phone's supposed to go. Right here is the actual charger. NFC chip is here. This is the volume down, volume up, plus, fast forward, rewind, pause, play. I'm gonna plug it up now so you guys can see. It's kind of hard to see those things unless it's actually plugged up. Before I do that, I'm gonna go to the back. So back here we have the audio in right here. Let me turn it around maybe for you guys. So we have the audio in right here. If you don't have a Bluetooth compatible device and you just want to stick it in via a 3.5 millimeter headphone jack, you can. Service, I guess, of any updates or something like that via micro USB, you can. I'm not sure if you can charge via this. I haven't tried it as of yet. DC in, that's what we'll be plugging this into, the on and off. I'm going to standby. I did want to let you guys know that if you do have a Qi compatible phone, as you guys will see right now, the device is not on, right? But you can place your device on top and it will charge. Okay, so it doesn't have to be on in order to charge. I apologize for the blurriness. Hopefully my Galaxy Nexus, there we go. I apologize for that. Got it right. Okay, so I'm not going to speak too much about the wireless capability. I mean, the charging aspect of the device. I'm going to do a full review of all of my Qi compatible devices in a separate video. Qi compatible chargers in a separate video with all the ones that I have. So, moving on though. Okay, so now I'm going to give you guys a video review of the quality of the sound. So right now I already have my phone paired up with it. It's essentially, you know, you tap the phone to the NFC, and it pairs like that. So I'm gonna play some music. Turn it down a little bit. Young nigga with his things low. Nice guy, just got a mean flow. Never seen rich, but he's seen poor. Mr. Dallas. Try a different type of music. Lows and mids are pretty good, fairly accurate. Play something a little different. Like when you said you felt so happy. Play some Jelly Roll Morton Maple Leaf right here. Some Morgan activator. You know, just different styles of music so you guys can listen and see. So as you guys can see, it does sound really good. I mean, well, I can't really say as you guys can see because I don't really know how YouTube is going to compress this video, the sound quality. But it is a very nice sounding speaker. Very, very nice sounding. Mids and lows are pretty on par. Highs, I think, could have a little bit more improvement. But, you know, it's very, very, very nice sounding, especially for a Bluetooth speaker. It does cost a pretty penny, so you would expect for it to sound relatively nice. Sorry about that. Notifications. So as you guys, obviously from that, you guys can tell, syncs to via Bluetooth, so that means your notifications and everything's going to play through it. Don't believe that phone call will not work. This would kind of be expected. Yeah. So, very, very nice sounding speaker. If you have a Qi compatible phone, in theory, it does work and it charges. Does it charge for the Nexus 4? Yes and no. Like I said, I will speak more about that later. I'm not going to delve into those details as of right now. I'm going to do a separate video reviewing all of my Qi chargers with the Nexus 4 so you guys can see about that. Another thing, important aspect about this is you're supposed to be able to just tap another device onto it and it's supposed to pair seamlessly. I'm going to demonstrate that for you guys right now. This is where it gets spotty. So I'm going to tap my wife's phone to see if it'll play. So as you guys can see clearly, it's not as seamless as they advertise it. Okay. So, see that took a little bit of time. It's just not as easy as you would think that it should be. Now, is it because this isn't a Nokia device and so it doesn't connect? I don't think so, because if I power the JBL speaker on or even before I paired it, like let's say for example I canceled, deleted the pairing settings and I tap it, it pairs quick and fast, that's not a problem, it'll play. But when it's interchanging between devices, it seems to take longer and sometimes it doesn't work. And that's one of the toting aspects of the device is that you'll be able to do that. That's what, you know, Nokia and JBL are advertising it as. But it just simply doesn't deliver as seamlessly or as easy as you would expect. So, yes. If you want a Bluetooth speaker, if, you know, you have a few few extra dollars and you want to go out and buy a Bluetooth speaker, by all means, this is the perfect speaker to get. Sound quality is ridiculously nice. Tap to NFC is good when it functions. That's important. I must note that. If you have a Nokia Lumia, I believe the 920 is the newest Windows phone. It seems to work seamlessly with their devices. For some reason, if you're outside of the Nokia bracket, it's just not as easy. I don't know why. NFC is NFC. Should work regardless. So I don't know why with that. But excellent Bluetooth speaker. Tap to NFC is nice when it works. If you're only operating with one device, it works seamlessly and great. You don't have anything to worry about. But if you're trying to tap between multiple devices, which is kind of what they advertise it as, it gets a little hairy. So would I say go out and buy this? Only if you have a Nokia device. If you have a Nexus 4, yes, you can still go out and buy it, but you're going to get some flaws, okay? You're going to get some negative aspects, which I already discussed there. Charging aspect, I will speak on that, like I said, in a later video. But I will say this, it charges the Nexus 4. Somewhat, okay? Details and everything like that I will get to later. But basically, if you're outside of the Nokia realm and you're debating about whether or not you should get this, yes and no. Like I said, it's a really nice speaker, but for the price that you're paying, you should be paying for something that works seamlessly with your device, not something where you have to accept some character flaws. So this is Hollis58 signing off. I hope you guys enjoyed my review. If you guys have any questions, please leave them in the comment section below and I will answer them as soon as I can. Thank you. See you guys later.